family, welcome to my channel. Make sure you guys hit that like button and subscribe to my channel. Right, so today I want to come to you guys today and just talk to you guys about, you know, self-accountability. Look, y'all, it's real out here, okay? It's real out here dealing with agents and fucking Decepticons, or aka your family, friends, and loved ones that take no self-accountability for the bullshit that they have done or not have done. They feel as though you and all the bullshit that you done endured and overcame, y'all, these motherfuckers feel like that is a fucking curse, okay? These motherfuckers feel like because you mustered up enough courage and strength to push yourself over that shit, to overcome those circumstances, those obstacles, and they can't do it, they feel like they are cursed. People need to cut their fucking shit out. I real life had somebody come to me about some black magic, right? And they were like, I want to do a return to sender spell. And I'm like, okay. But when I read the cards, no cards of black magic popped up. All the cards that popped out was self-accountability. Okay? So, I say this to say, self-accountability is the number one factor of if you're going to sink or swim. Because if you know that you are responsible for your fucking survival, you're going to motherfucking swim. But if you think somebody about to crack the sky and save your ass, is when your bitch ass is going to drown. Self-accountability, people. Self-accountability. I had another situation when somebody was coming to me and they wanted to tell me that something in their life major has happened, but they didn't want to take accountability. So how they presented the information was as a curiosity. What does this mean? And so when I said, well, this means that this is that, and then they're like, yeah, I can see, not I am that thing and this is my truth. They still hid behind it. Yeah, I don't know. I'll check into it, you know, I'll get back with you on that type of shit. Self-accountability. And I can go into details, but for the sake of, you know, for the sake of confidentiality, because I take being a spiritualist very, very serious. Okay, for the sake of confidentiality, I don't want to go into too many, many details so that you can either figure out who it is if you know me, or you can figure out what they said or what the situation was about. So that's why I'm being so vague, but you guys can fill in the parts that you need to fill in for your reality, okay? So going forward, so, you know, my advice to them, just like my advice, y'all, excuse me, I need to probably pull over and tighten my phone screen thing up, the thing that holds the phone. But moving forward, so, you know, in order for this person to understand the level of fuckery they placed upon themselves, they have to start with accountability first. And this person is not in a state of accountability just yet, because if you are the first to do something, that's one thing, but if this is a repeated pattern, it might be a generational curse. And who is responsible for breaking off generational curses? You are responsible for, or are responsible for breaking off generational curses out of your fucking life. And if you not gonna do it, you're gonna live the same reality that most of your loved ones have lived. This is a fact on fact. So it starts with self-accountability. I don't give, and I say this in so many of my videos, because I don't give a damn how much herbs, oils, and fucking spells you do. It's gonna come to a point in your life and in your spiritual path and in your desire and wanting that you're gonna have to have some self-accountability, period. So the faster and sooner you obtain and have self-accountability, the faster and sooner you can move forward in your life. It's simple. It's not complicated. But to a weak-minded individual, the concept of you being in absolute control of your reality is far beyond them. They have no fucking idea. They're clueless. They don't know. They're like, I'm in control. No, I've been told all my life that God is in control and Jesus is in control. That's true to a degree, but you also got free will. You free will been fucking your back loose. You free will been drugging yourself up. You free will been self-sabotaging yourself. You free will been hating on your own motherfucking self for years. God ain't came and saved your ass yet, has he? Because you still doing it. Just because you paint that shit don't mean that it ain't what it is. Shit is shit. I don't give a fuck if you glitterize that motherfucker. Because y'all know I like to bedazzle and beglitter everything. That's my word. Everybody else say glitterize. I say beglitter. Because goddamn it, it's bedazzle. So bedazzle and beglitter. I am a beglitter and a bedazzle fucking freak. I'm talking about everything I do is just glitterized. Okay? I am a unicorn and I fucking like glitter. You feel me? So, you know, it's one of those things where it don't matter what you paint that shit, it's still shit. And that's why you have to understand what real value is. So you're not around here painting shit and it's still shit. That you painting stuff that is a value, adding more value to it. I don't give a damn how much I beglitter, bedazzle, or paint some shit and try to sell it to somebody. Guess what they gonna say? Y'all know, ain't nobody paying for that shit. They know that it's shit under there. Maybe it's telltale signs that it's shit. Maybe you're a good enough artist, you can hide the fact that it's shit. But the whole point is this shit, ain't nobody buying shit. So it's time for us to be self-accountable and walk in the reality of what is really going on. Because when we walk in the reality of actually what is really going on, now we have the opportunity to change the way things are going and how things end up. That's why it's important that we take self-accountability, so that we can save ourselves and not ask God to exhaust his energy to save us when we can save ourselves. Hopefully this message has been a blessing. I am at the store. I'm about to go in the store, so I gotta get off. But peace, light, and love, family. Until the next time. Peace.